Hi everyone, welcome to the second video in a series where we'll be covering everything you need to know about IRL live streaming. We're actually going to build on the last couple of videos with a broad overview of how everything works, from streaming directly to a platform like Twitch and YouTube, to streaming with a middleman service like your computer at home. Let's start with three core parts to IRL live streaming. There's your IRL gear, an optional middleman service, and the platform or platforms you'll be streaming to. For you, your IRL gear will be a mobile phone, but this can extend to other streaming devices like a Bellabox or LiveView. The end result is you're broadcasting a live video from whatever IRL gear you're using, like a phone, to somewhere else, like the platform or middleman service first. In this first example, my IRL gear is the combination of my phone and the YouTube app. It's a fine app, but lacks a proper mechanism to handle mobile disconnects. Regular IRL live streamers quickly realize how important this is. Anyway, some examples of apps that can do a direct live stream to a platform include the Twitch app, YouTube, Streamlabs, Larix, and IRL Pro. And there are times when it's easier, more convenient, or maybe when all else fails, to use a direct live stream instead of something more robust. That brings us to the Streamlabs mobile app, which I talked about in this other video. From what I can tell, it has a two-fold system. You can stream to a platform directly, or tap into one of their middleman services like Disconnect Protection. For this, and according to their website, they open a private server hosted on the cloud. This perfectly demonstrates the relationship between the three core parts to IRL live streaming I mentioned earlier. In this example, the IRL gear was my phone and the Streamlabs mobile app. In order to use their disconnect protection feature for free, I had to redeem it in their app first. This activates a middleman service, which is one of their private servers. When I start broadcasting from my phone, it goes through their private server before reaching the live streaming platform. If I forget, and I've done this, to redeem disconnect protection, the stream becomes a direct one, so there's no private server, meaning my stream would end whenever there's a problem with my mobile connection. Finally, there's what I'll be helping you to set up, and that's using your home computer as your own personal middleman service. Your computer can do most of what's offered online, but at a fraction of the cost, and if you ever decide to swap one out for the other, you can do that too. For example, in some of my other videos, I talked about using Bellabox Cloud with your home setup, and in this sense, they're both middleman services. Circumstances could also mean you put everything in the cloud instead of one from home. It's basically whatever works for you. Anyway, I'm jumping ahead of myself. We'll talk about them and more in a future video. For now, let's look at this other example. My IRL gear is the combination of my phone and the IRL Pro app for Android. For iPhone, there's Larix, Streamcaster, Moblin, and others. I'm broadcasting from IRL Pro to my home computer as the middleman service between my gear and the streaming platform. In this part of the video, my home computer is recording the broadcast from my phone, but it could have been actual live stream or both. The two other desktop applications you see are being used to control what my viewers see, like showing a friendly be right back message when there's a problem with my mobile connection. It's where you can set up alerts, overlays, and more as well. Basically, the middleman service here is taking the IRL broadcast from my phone, handling what happens when there's a problem with the connection, adding its own overlays and stuff before the video is rebroadcast to the streaming platform. There's actually one last part to all this, and it feeds back into your IRL gear, and that's a second support device or phone. You can see it near the end of the demo video where I'm using a different app to remotely start and stop the recording of my IRL broadcast. We'll be covering lots of different ways of doing this, whether you're on a Mac or Windows PC. Hopefully this video gives you a broad overview of what does what and the relationship between them. So when I talk about a live stream, it could be the broadcast from my phone to my home computer, or it could be from my home computer to the streaming platform. Knowing some of these things now will make the rest of the videos in the series easier to understand, and if you decide to change up your IRL gear or middleman services. Anyway, that's all for this video. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next one.